Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome everybody. So let us start the second lecture of the chapter Chemical Equilibrium. And the topic for today's lecture is Law of Mass Action and Equilibrium constant case. So these are the topics for the lecture number 2. Now, law of mass action was first presented by C.M. Goldberg and P. Waitz in 1864. According to this law of mass action, suppose that there is a reaction in which A and B, they react together to form C and D in a reversible manner. Then according to law of mass action, the rate of a reaction is directly proportional to product of the molar concentration of the reactants. And keep your one thing in your mind, that here the square brackets, they are showing the molar concentration. Molar concentration means concentration of a species in mole per decimeter cube. And this law that we are going to study in this lecture, that is valid when you are taking the molar concentration or concentration in mole per decimeter cube for dilute solutions. So this law will be valid only for the dilute solutions. And these square brackets are showing the molar concentration of A and molar concentration of B in the dilute solution. So according to law of mass action, rate of a reaction is directly proportional to the product of molar concentration of the reactants. Just like the rate of forward reaction is directly proportional to molar concentration of A and molar concentration of B. Replacing the sign of proportionality with equality, there will be used a constant, that is the rate constant for forward reaction. So this one is the equation number 1. Similarly for reverse reaction, the rate of reverse or backward reaction, that will be directly proportional to molar concentration of C into molar concentration of D. Because in reverse direction, C and D are the reactants and A and B are the products. So you will take the product of molar concentration of the reactants of the backward reaction. Or rate of backward reaction, that will be equal to rate constant of backward reaction, molar mass of molar sorry concentration of C into molar concentration of D. Now this one is equation number 2. We know that at the state of dynamic equilibrium, the rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. So compare these 1 and 2. If their left sides are equal, then the right side must also be equal. So the value of rate of forward reaction is this one, Kf into A and B and that is kb into c and d. So we have just put the value of rate of forward reaction here and rate of backward reaction here. This one is the value of rate of backward reaction. Now rearrange this equation. Kf over kb, that will be equal to product of molar concentration of c and d divided by product of molar concentration of a and b. Now this one is the ratio between the rate constant of forward reaction and rate constant of the backward reaction, and the ratio of the rate constant of forward and backward reaction, that is called as rate constant. Rate constant is shown with the symbol k, but because we are taking all this rate constant in terms of the molar concentration, so c is written in the subscript, and this c shows that this is the rate constant in terms of the molar concentration of the reactants and products. That will be equal to c into d divided by a into b. So this one is the expression for the for the equilibrium constant in terms of concentration, and this expression is also called as the equilibrium law or you may say law of equilibrium. Now in this particular case I have taken the coefficient of the reactants and products as unity. You can see that the stoichiometric coefficient of A is 1, stoichiometric coefficient of B is also 1, and similarly the stoichiometric coefficient of C and D, they are also equal to the 1. But if the stoichiometric coefficients are not 1, like A is the stoichiometric coefficient of A, B is the coefficient of B, C is for C and D for D, then what will be the formula of the equilibrium constant? So similarly, the formula is written as molar concentration of C, D divided by molar concentration of A and B. And the coefficients of the balanced equation, they become the exponents. So the coefficient of C is C, it will become its exponent. Similarly, D, A and B, they will become the exponents of the molar concentrations. So this one is the case if the stoichiometric coefficients are the coefficients of balanced equation, they are not equal to 1, and if they are equal to 1, then similar simple case of this KC formula is applied. So you can say that KC is actually the ratio between the equilibrium concentration of products and equilibrium concentration of reactants. This one is actually the equilibrium constant. Now, what are the factors that affect this equilibrium constant? So the first factor is the most important one, that is temperature. Temperature affects the equilibrium constant. Kc is directly proportional to temperature when the reaction is endothermic. And Kc is inversely proportional to temperature when the reaction is exothermic. So for endothermic reactions, direct relation between Kc and temperature is seen. And for exothermic, reverse relation between the equilibrium constant and temperature is there. The second factor is the mode of reaction. Suppose we write a reaction that A plus B goes to form C plus T. And then the Kc for this reaction is the product of molar concentration of products divided by product of molar concentration of reactants. And suppose that is equal to K. Its value is K. But if we write down the reverse reaction for this, then the Kc will be product of concentration of A and B divided by product of molar concentration of C and D. Keep in mind that this molar concentration of C and D in this formula and the molar concentration of C and D here, they both will be equal. Similarly, the molar concentration of A and B here and here, they will be equal. But now the equilibrium constant will be its reciprocal. It will be 1 over K. Because the numerator and denominator, they are reversed. So you can say that the equilibrium constant of the reverse reaction is reciprocal of the equilibrium constant of the forward reaction. Now, what is the third factor? That is the coefficients of balanced chemical equation. Suppose I am writing a reaction in which 2 moles of hydrogen iodide, they decompose to form 1 mole of hydrogen gas and 1 mole of iodine in the gaseous form. And this hydrogen iodide is also in the gaseous form. What will be the Kc? That will be molar concentration of hydrogen into molar concentration of iodine divided by molar concentration of hydrogen iodide square, because again the coefficient will become the exponent, and this is suppose that is equal to K. Now if 1 mole of hydrogen iodide is there and that decomposes to form 1/2 mole of hydrogen gas and 1/2 mole of iodine gas. Now the Kc will be written as molar concentration of hydrogen square root, iodine square root divided by molar concentration of HI. Now if you will compare this with this one, then this should be equal to, its value should be equal to, as compared to K, it should be K square root or K raised to power 1 by 2. Simply, if you want to make this formula equal to this one, then you will have to take square of this. And you, when you will take square of K, this square root of the K, it will become equal to the K. So this Kc is actually the square root of the above Kc. So by changing the, if it is 4, it will be 2. So by changing the stoichiometric coefficient, the value of Kc that also changes. The next factor is fourth one, other equilibrium constants. Now Kc changes if you will change Kp, Kx or Kn. Kp is the equilibrium constant in terms of pressure, Kx is the equilibrium constant in terms of mole fraction, and Kn is the equilibrium constant in terms of the number of moles. So if you will change any of these constants, then Kc will also be changed. Simply, all these equilibrium constants, they are interrelated to each other. If any one of them is changed, others automatically change. So these are the four factors that affect the Kc. Now let us discuss those factors that do not affect the equilibrium constant. So what are the factors that do not affect? Initial concentration of reactants, pressure or volume of reaction mixer, catalyst. So these are some factors that do not affect Kc. If you will change the initial concentration of reactants, that will not make any difference. Similarly, pressure and volume of the reaction mixer, presence or absence of catalyst. So these are the factors that do not affect the equilibrium constant. Now at the last, let us discuss the units of Kc. What are the units of Kc? Keep one thing in your mind, that if a reaction is there like 2 moles of hydrogen iodide are decomposed to form hydrogen plus iodine. In this case, the number of moles of reactants, they are 2. Similarly, the number of moles of products, total number of moles, they are also 2, 1 plus 2, 1 plus 1, that is equal to 2. So number of moles of reactants, that is equal to number of moles of products. And when number of moles of reactants are equal to the number of moles of products, then Kc has no units. How? Kc will be equal to molar concentration of hydrogen into molar concentration of iodine divided by molar concentration of hydrogen iodide square. So just putting their units, these are molar concentration, so it should be mole per liter or mole per decimeter cube into mole per decimeter cube of iodine divided by mole per decimeter cube hydrogen iodide and square. So this will also become square of the mole per decimeter cube, and square will be cancelled with this square. So finally Kc will have no units. But if there is some reaction like Haber process, N2 plus 3H2 goes to form 2NH3. Then, first of all, the total number of moles of reactants are 4 and total number of moles of products are 2. So, number of moles of reactants, they are not equal to number of moles of products. Now, in this particular case, Kc will have certain units. Well, what will be the units of the Kc now? Concentration of ammonia raised to power 2 divided by concentration of N2 into concentration of hydrogen cube. Now, putting the units only, mole per decimeter cube square divided by mole per decimeter cube into mole per decimeter cube. Now it will become मोल पर डेसीमीटर क्यूब स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय इट्स पावर इज 3, इट्स पावर इज 1, कंबाइनिंग दीज टू मोल पर डेसीमीटर क्यूब रेज टू पावर 4. नाउ रीअरेंज दिस वन, इट विल बी मोल पर डेसीमीटर क्यूब रेज टू पावर माइनस 2. बिकॉज दिस 4 दैट विल बी कैंसल्ड विथ दिस 2 एंड हेयर विल बी ओनली 2. एंड वेन दिस 2 विल मूव टूवर्ड्स द ऑपोजिट साइड टूवर्ड्स द न्यूमिरेटर, देन इट विल बिकम माइनस 2. एंड द यूनिट्स ऑफ केसी विल बी मोल पर डेसीमीटर क्यूब रेज टू पावर माइनस 2. सो यू कैन राइट इट डाउन एज मोल माइनस 2 प्लस 6. दिस वन विल बी द यूनिट्स ऑफ द केसी. फाइनली इफ द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स एंड प्रोडक्ट्स आर इक्वल देन केसी हैज नो यूनिट्स. बट इफ द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स आर ग्रेटर देन नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स और नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स आर लेस देन नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स, इन बोथ दीज केसेस केसी हैज यूनिट्स. एंड देर इज अ शॉर्टकट टू फाइंड द यूनिट्स ऑफ द केसी, डेट इज मोल पर डेसीमीटर क्यूब रेज टू पावर एन पी माइनस एन आर. यू कैन अप्लाई दिस शॉर्टकट वाइल सॉल्विंग द एमसीक्यूज. सपोज डेट दिस वन इज द रिएक्शन एंड इन द एमसीक्यूज इट इज आस्क्ड दैट व्हाट विल बी द यूनिट्स ऑफ द केसी, देन यू आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू डू ऑल दिस कैलकुलेशन. सिंपली व्हाट विल बी द यूनिट्स ऑफ केसी, डेट विल बी मोल पर डेसीमीटर क्यूब, द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स आर 2 माइनस द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स आर 4. सो 2 माइनस 4 that will be minus 2, and when you will solve it again it will become this one. So that will be the unit of the KC. This is the shortcut to find the unit of the KC, but this shortcut is applied only when you are solving the MCQs. If the short question is asked at what will be the units of KC for a particular reaction, then you will have to do all these calculations. So this was all about the law of mass action and the introduction to the equilibrium constant. Next time, inshallah, we will come up with some new lectures. Till then, Allah Hafiz.